I am a name robot. It's Tinkertime.
It's Tinkertime. Hey, Tinkerers, I'm Nene, and today we are going to be making a robotic hand. Ooh. We're going to be doing this for two reasons. One, because it is a super fun experiment. And another, because I'm really fascinated by our hands and the way that they work. I think we take our hands for granted all the time. We expect them to pick things up, scratch our nose, hold things. It's just, you know, that's a really big job. Well done, hand. So, Tinkers, what I want you to do is have a look at the way your hand bends down at the joints like this. Can you do that with your hands? And watch the places in which it bends. Now I want you to hold out your hand like this, and then I want you to press on your palm. And as you do that, the tendons of your hand pull in. So you see, running up and down through every finger is a tendon, and they all join through in this part of your hand, the palm of your hand. And that's what helps you bend and grab things. So we're going to be doing an experiment that shows us how that works. So first you're going to need some cardboard, straws, a ruler, scissors, really strong glue, some string, and perhaps something like this wooden skewer. All right, so first things first, we're going to be making...
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, Mom. We're going to be making our hand shape. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my hand onto the cardboard. The bigger the hand, the easier this experiment is going to be. So try and find the biggest hand in your house. Whoa, that's a big hand, dude. Yeah, try and use that hand, place it on the cardboard, and then we're going to trace around it, just like this. That's the way. Now, once you've traced around your hand, I want you to very carefully choose some scissors or a Stanley knife and cut that hand out.
Oh no, I got texture on my hand.
All right, let's go. Cutting cardboard can be tricky work, so you might need some help with this. And I'm going to cut in and around each finger. There we go. All right, so what we need to do here is now find out where the joints on this hand is. So at the moment, my hand, straight face, doesn't want to bend at all. So I need to find those sections where my hand is bending. So you see each finger on your hand, you can see the little lines, and that's the area in which your hand bends. And on your thumb, there's only one, and then you have a fair bit of movement in this joint here. And so I want you to mark on your hand those areas where the joints are bending, because we're going to put some folds in the cardboard just there. Is by using my ruler to help create those folds. So I take my ruler and I push it into the cardboard where I want the bend to happen, just like that. See, it bends over there. Makes that folding much easier. Push into the cardboard and then I've got the two joints bending there. And same again. That's the way. Now you can see that my hand is starting to fold similar to my real hand. Now what you need to do is take some drinking straws, cut some small pieces, one for each part of that finger. So I have all my little pieces of straw, and now what I need to do is attach them to my hand. So in this little jar, I've got some little PVA wood glue, and I'm gonna put a little dollop on each part of the hand like this. And that's where we're going to be attaching our little pieces of straw. Now, if you want this to dry super fast, you could also use a hot glue gun, but you've got to be really careful with hot glue guns. So using my PVA wood glue, now I'm going to place my pieces of straw on. Now I need them to be pointing straight down towards the center. Now what I want to do is cut some slightly longer pieces. Oh, come back. And you need five of them because we have four fingers and a thumb. 4 + 1 = 5. Nailed it. So I'm going to place a line of glue running up to those other pieces of straw, just like that. Then I'm going to place the longer pieces of straw in that glue. Just like that. Now we have to let the glue dry to make it nice and strong. So the PVA glue is still taking a little while to dry, but here I've used a faster drying glue so we can continue work with our hand immediately. Now what we need to do here is we're going to have to run pieces of string from the top of the finger down through into the wrist area. And this is how we're going to do it. So you can use any sort of string for this, but what we don't want is for that string to be stretchy at all, because it's going to have to pull the fingers down to show us how the tendons work. Now what we need to do is we need a way of catching the string at the top of the fingers. So what I've got here is a wooden skewer that we would be using for sometimes for barbecuing. Now what I've done is I've cut a tiny piece of wood off that skewer, and then I'm going to tie my string in a knot around the skewer there. Might do a double knot just so that we know that it's nice and strong. So now that tiny piece of wood is going to catch the string at the top of the hand. Think about how much I need. Then I'm going to cut the piece of string. Now watch me as I thread this piece of string through the straws here. Ah, stay through. Quite tricky. If anyone's doing sewing at home, you might find this bit quite easy. It's kind of like threading a needle. So you can see I've got my string through the straws there. Careful to leave my wood chip at the end. And now I need to thread it through the final piece of straw, like that. And then I'm going to do that for every single finger. Here we go.
Don't know how to solve it. Can you fix it with me? We'll start working through it. Every possible solution. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Some problems need a hammer. Some problems need some glue. Gonna jump right in it, 'cause I can't wait to begin it. Try to see what I can do. It's time. It's time.
So there you have it. We've finished our cardboard robotic hand. There they go. Wow, she's a beauty. So it's interesting the way we think about how those tendons in our fingers pull downwards. There's our thumb, there's our pointer finger, our middle finger, and our pinky. Interesting, when I pulled down the middle finger, some of the others want to go with it. And even when you do that on your own hand, kind of hard to get that middle finger down without the others moving with it, isn't it? Because they're all connected. So there we have it. That's our robotic hand. Oh, now before we go bye-bye, I just wanted to show you a marvelous robotic hand I worked on yesterday. Bit complicated to make in the Tinkertime room today. But check this out. 1, 2. Oh. Whoa! You want to see me have a go at this puppy? Yeah, you do. Wow. Here we go. So I'm going to place my hand inside. And then for each finger, I've created a loop that can attach to my own finger. Now, this is not a perfect invention, but pretty fun.
let's get this on and see what we can do with this baby. And this one, I started with elastic, didn't work, too bendy. And now you can see that my straw connection tendon comes all the way over the back of the hand into here. And then what I did was create this extra latch here with the Velcro just to hold the whole arm in place nice and tight. Oh! Now find that thumb hard to do. There he goes. Pretty interesting, isn't it? Watch this. Oh! Now that's a robotic hand. Thumb, thumb, thumb. I wonder.
So, you behave. Hey, let's play. See what the world can show us. Hey, let's play. And show the world what we know. Hey,
you,
it's you. Join in the
play. Make the most of everything. See you next week, Tinkers, for more Tinkering Adventures.